Tonight's top European Union stories from the Unit UK include: Europe wants its Parmesan back and seeks a name change. Royal Bank of Scotland could move headquarters to England if Scotland joins the EU. Former Labour leader boss keep still. Former Labour leader boss keep still for a referendum on the euro. Brits swing towards in for the first time, YouGov poll. Plus, EU to address rule of law issues. It's Friday, 21st of March. Great to have you with me. I'm Rick Timmis, and this is the Unit Nightly News. First up, from our homepage on our website, theunituk.com, Europe wants its Parmesan back and seeks a name change. Would Parmesan by any other name be as tasty atop your pasta? A ripening trade battle might put that to the test. As part of trade talks, the European Union wants to ban the use of European names like Parmesan, Feta and Gorgonzola on cheese made in the United States. The argument is that the American-made cheeses are shadows of the original European varieties and cut into sales and identity of the European cheeses. The Europeans say Parmesan should only come from Parma, Italy, not those familiar green cylinders that American companies sell. Feta should only come from Greece, even though feta isn't a place. And the EU argues it is so closely connected to Greece as to be identified as an inherently Greek product. Well, you can park this one with the Stilton and Cornish pasties. RBS could move headquarters to England if Scotland joins the EU. The Royal Bank of Scotland and other Scottish-based financial firms might have to move their headquarters to England if Scotland becomes independent and joins the European Union, Bank of England Governor Mark Carney said on Tuesday. Carney said if Scotland chose to break away from the rest of the United Kingdom at a September 18th referendum, EU law stipulated it would need to guarantee deposits in England and Scotland, where many have their largest customer bases. Former Labour leader boss keeps still for a referendum on the euro. First the Catalonians, then the Italians in Veneta, and now the Dutch are queuing up to get out of the EU. Former Labour leader Wouter Bos is holding a referendum on whether the Netherlands should preserve the euro. Now, that referendum would provide him a clear choice, should be for or against Europe, he said last night during a debate in Dubali. Yes means yes to the euro and yes to banking authorities and relief, said Forrest, and no means no, with all its consequences, referring to an exit from the European Monetary Union. A referendum, he said, the only way to provide democratic legitimacy on European integration. Brits swing towards in for the first time, YouGov poll. More Britons would vote to stay in the European Union than leave it, a poll showed today. The first time the in camp has been ahead since Prime Minister David Cameron's last year pledged a referendum on Britain's membership. Cameron has promised to offer Britons an in-out referendum on whether to leave the 28-nation EU if he wins a national election next year. Now, under pressures from Eurosceptics in his Conservative Party and the anti-EU UK Independence Party ahead of European elections in May and the 2015 general election, Cameron has promised to first try to reshape Britain's ties with the EU. Reshape, renegotiate, repatriate. It's all the same, and it won't wash with Barroso, Schultz and Reding and Merkel, all of whom are dead set against any renegotiation between Britain and the EU. the European Union to address rule of law issues. The European Commission will today unveil new powers to intervene in countries where there is a threat to the rule of law, in a bid to take a tough line with member states in breach of EU principles. Concerns about the abuse of judicial and legal frameworks in countries including Romania and Hungary have surfaced in recent years, with Hungary coming under increased scrutiny after Viktor Orban's government introduced constitutional amendments limiting the powers of Hungary's top court. Justice Commissioner Viviane Reding will today announce a three-stage process that will allow the European Commission to intervene if it perceives a systemic threat to the rule of law in member states. So, folks, there you have it, straight from the horse's mouth. Not that I'm calling Viviane Reding a horse, but the bottom line is more legal dominance for the EU to pull rogue member states into line. Now, remember, visit our website, theunituk.com, for all the very latest news. You can find our page on Facebook by searching for The Unit UK, all one word. Join our community on Google Plus, where you can interact with us, voice your opinions, and post comments about our stories, and even get involved in the shows. For all the latest tweets as they happen, then follow us on Twitter at The E Unit. And of course, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. I'm Rick Timmis, reporting for The Unit Nightly News. I'll see you soon.